This car is so pristine, I've been very hesitant to actually take it out and drive it, knowing myself. It is restored with parts that are so hard to find, and it is absolutely put together exactly the way they came from Shelby when it left the hangar in Los Angeles. I'm about to meet with my restoration team, John Brown, Jason Aker, and Jeff Catlin. We're going to go into depth into the history of this very special GT350. This car came up for sale, and it was being offered for sale from the original family that owned the car.
The family, there were brothers, and the one brother swapped the car with his other, and that guy liked to race motorcycles, so when we got this car, it actually had a trailer hitch on the back, so he could haul his dirt bikes around, and going to the track one day, he got kind of pushed off to the road from somebody coming the other way, and he went into the ditch, and he hit a rock underneath the car, right about where the idler arm sits, so the wheels turned at different rates, and it was very undrivable, and he just got kind of fed up, and they parked the car in the garage, and then that's where we found it, which is why it has such low miles on.
And that's why we thought it was such a great car to start with. Jason fixed all those parts when it was at John's. Jason Aker was part of Gas Monkey when this car came out of the garage, was put on the trailer when Dennis Collins bought it. Also knowing that you had restored my 66 GT350 convertible.
Well, there wouldn't have been another time at Gas Monkey, I got more excited than seeing this 65 roll up on the trailer, because first thought was they got another clone. Here's, you know, it's a nice car, but then once I got out and started snooping around, I realized it was a real car, and then I got real excited. Then I saw the mileage, and then I made a phone call to John Brown. And John, being my mentor, taught me years and years ago, got me cut into these cars. So yeah, it just goes full circle. I knew what to look for, I knew who to call.
So I went to John Brown's shop, looked at the car as they were just taking it apart, and went over everything that needed to be done.
We went over the whole car and went through every single part, said, okay, this is original, this is not, this is original, this is not, it's gonna need this, you're gonna have to do this, and so we had all that laid out. Craig basically said, I wanna build the finest Shelby, 65 Shelby in existence. And so to do that, you basically have to start all over on the car. You have to strip the car totally down, and you have to bring the car back up just like the factory built the car originally. The car that's built to this level, you have to start with a really good car. You can't start with a rusty car. You can't start with a car that's been wrecked. You can't start with a car that's been used and abused, so to speak. You have to start with a pristine car, because you're not going to be able to get it back to the level that it needs to be. And every single piece of the car is addressed. Every single nut and bolt, every single part of the car is either replaced or rebuilt and restored back to the way it was originally. The first show we took it to was Tulsa Concourse, and we brought all of the best judges in the country in to look the car over, to kind of, as a kind of prepare for the Shelby Club Concourse and also the Mustang Club of America Concourse. So that was its first show out, kind of a debut. Let's see what it does. It did real well. It scored a gold at Tulsa. When it went to the Shelby Club show, it got a gold and got premier at Shelby Club, which is the highest level that it can win. It's the only 65 Shelby at the time to have won that award. When it went to MCA, it scored a gold in the Thoroughbred class, which is the hardest class that MCA has, Mustang Club of America. And not only that, it also won the Authenticity Award, which means it has to have 99% of the original parts on the car. And these are not just new old stock, these are assembly line parts. It has to have almost every single part has to be perfect. There's only been 5 65 Shelbys ever to win SAAC Premier Award.
The car is exactly as it won, except I had to put a couple of parts on it so that I could actually drive it. The car was a 19,000 mile original car with an original interior in it. People ask, why am I selling it? Because it is so perfect. I drive all of my cars. I race this Shelby. I drive the Hornet. I drive Little Red. I drive every one of my cars, and this car is so pristine, I don't trust myself to drive it. Those unobtainable parts will be non-usable parts when I'm done.
So this is a small representation of some of the parts that we used on the car. In order to find the parts that are needed to build a car like this, it usually takes a couple of years to do. We managed to do it in about 9 months. And through just searching on eBay and calling people that we know have parts, but you can't go down to the dealer and order parts like this anymore. Some of these parts have been obsolete for 30, 40 years.
Now these are historic in themselves, and that's why I wanted the boxes need to go with the car.
There are some parts on the car that are basically non-existent. There only exists one set or one copy.
And we share them.
And they have to be shared for various cars around the country.
This was about an education. I learned a lot doing this, and that was part of it. This was a process for all of us at Barrett-Jackson, and I've met a lot of great people that have now become part of the family through doing this project, and we wanted to share that with you. This is about knowledge, and Barrett-Jackson's been about entertainment, but educating people while we entertain you at the live auctions. These behind the scenes are to give you a snapshot into cars. This one's on a whole nother level though. So I hope you've enjoyed this. If you love a car like this, come to the auction. It's selling no reserve in March, Scottsdale 2021.